Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, friends. If you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, do subscribe it today and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. In this video, we will see how to fix if you cannot sign into Microsoft account in Windows 11 operating system. So let's get started. So if you are not able to sign into Microsoft account while using any of the features in Windows 11 operating system, this video will show you different solutions you can try to fix this problem. For your reference, here is the Microsoft account sign-in window looks like. And in case if you are not able to type anything on this window, or if this window keeps freezing, or if nothing happens when you click on the next button, or any other issue you are facing while trying to sign into this window, we will try to fix it in this video. So here is our first solution. In this case, we will right click on the start button and select run, type %localappdata % and then press the enter key. When the local app data folder opens, double click on the Microsoft folder there. Now inside Microsoft folder, you will find credential folders, which is empty in this case. On other system, it might have some data. All you need to do is just rename the credentials folder to credentials.old. And once you do this, try to restart the system and see if the issue is resolved. Now coming to the solution number 2. In case if solution number 1 doesn't work, you can continue your troubleshooting. In this case, we will right click on the start button and select run, type regedit and click OK. Click yes in the user account control confirmation prompt. When the registry editor window opens, go to /etc/users/default, software, Microsoft, identity CRL, stored identities, then you will find a subkey named to your email ID for the Microsoft account. All you need to do is just export this registry key for your reference. And this is an optional step. Then once you export the registry key, you can just delete the registry key. Click yes in this confirmation prompt and the registry key will be deleted. Make sure to reboot your system and then try signing in with Microsoft account again, and this time it should work. Up next is the solution number 3. In this case, we will again right click on the start button and select run. This time we will type secpol.msc in order to open local security policy snap-in. In local security policy snap-in, go to security settings, local policies, security options. In right pane of security options, you will be able to locate accounts, then block Microsoft accounts, which is not defined by default. But in case if you are facing this issue, the policy might be set to users can't add Microsoft accounts, or users can't add or log on with Microsoft accounts. All you need to do is just set this policy to this policy is disabled. And when you set it to this policy is disabled, blocked Microsoft accounts should not be happening. You can also refer to the policy explanation for more details here. Once you apply the policy, make sure to update the group policy engine by running /gpupdate /force command, or you can also restart the system to make changes effective. And once you restart the system, you should be able to sign into your Microsoft account without any problem. Now coming to the last solution, that is solution number 4. In this case, we will again right click on the start button and select run. Type regedit and click OK. Click yes in the user account control confirmation prompt. In the registry editor window, in the registry location bar, paste this registry location from video description and press the enter key. When you arrive to the right pane of system registry key, you will find enable LUA named registry dword value. All you need to do is just set this value data to 1 and click OK. Once you set this value data to 1 and restart your system, you should be able to sign into your Microsoft account without any problem. If you still face this issue, do let me know your comments. I'll be happy to help you. And that's it for now in this video. Thanks for watching it. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.